Greetings again, ecotopians. So far in this class, we've been talking mostly about what I call abiotic factors in ecosystems, geology and weather. Abiotic meaning non-living, the non-living parts of ecosystems. And we're moving towards the biotic factors of ecosystems. Those are the living kind parts of ecosystems. And today's lecture is going to be kind of a segue into that, looking at how energy is used on the planet by living things. So we'll go to this PowerPoint here. Going to give you the full picture, I hope. There we go. Okay, this is a picture of the sun. It's false color. They've darkened it up a little bit so you can see the really, really hot parts of it. This, I think, is some solar storm, maybe a coronal mass ejection or a sunspot or something like that. And so, yes, we live in the solar system, and the sun is at the middle of it, and it's bathing us all with incredibly huge amounts of energy all the time. And here is a picture of our lovely planet. It's absolutely gorgeous, isn't it? And I just want to draw your attention to a few things. First of all, there's a lot of water on the planet, and that's good because I like water. Water is good, keeps us alive. And notice the reflection of the sun. So the sun is bathing our planet in energy all the time, light energy, all the other kinds of energy. That drives the weather, and it drives all living stuff too, as you'll see in this lecture. You can also see just barely on the edge of our lovely planet is a very thin envelope of atmosphere. And that's good because I like to breathe. We breathe and we need the air for a number of different reasons. And one reason is that this thin blanket of atmosphere keeps us warm, actually. It traps a little bit of the sun's energy before it gets reflected out into outer space and goes wherever it's going to go. And it traps it, and it keeps our planet at a certain temperature, which just happens to be perfect for us. Either we are evolved to, or we are adapted to this temperature, or we're just lucky as hell. I don't know. I'm concerned that we have polluted this atmosphere with a lot of CO2 greenhouse gases. We've about doubled the amount of greenhouse gases as existed in the atmosphere before the Industrial Revolution, and so we are concerned about climate change, but that is a subject for another time. So on this planet, we also have plants. And so plants, you probably already know that plants do photosynthesis, and photosynthesis is a big deal. But I want to take that apart a little bit in this lecture so that I am sure that you understand how important plants and photosynthesis is. So the way I approach this with my students is through what I call the equation of life on Earth. Now, equation, what's an equation? It's a mathematical thing, or it's a chemistry thing. This plus that equals that. That's what the equation of life on Earth is. But wow, I'm excited because we have one equation. And there are a lot of biological equations out there for sure, but we can summarize all life on Earth in one equation. That's powerful. That's good. So, the equation of life on Earth, not this equation? What's that mean? Let's see. Yeah, right. Not that equation for sure. Not that kind of life. That was really cool background music. I think it was Beethoven or something. Da, 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 da. Anyway, so what equation am I talking about? Okay, so an equation, the equation of life on Earth I'm talking about, starts with some stuff and is converted to some other stuff, and that other stuff at some point is converted back to this stuff. So there's a back and forth cycling involved in this equation. That's the first point. The second point is there's something else that enters this equation that passes through it and comes out the other side. That does not cycle. Okay, let's get to the meat of it. What is it? Okay, so here is photosynthesis. Water, that's H2O, plus carbon dioxide. Water plus carbon dioxide is converted into biomass, and there's a waste product of oxygen, O2 gas. Okay, so this going to that is photosynthesis, but as I just mentioned, it also goes the other way. Biomass plus oxygen converts to dihydrogen oxide, water, and carbon dioxide. What's that? That is cellular respiration. Respiration, you maybe think respiration is breathing. Well, to biologists and biochemists, cellular respiration means the burning of biomass in our bodies with oxygen, in the presence of oxygen, to release energy and also two waste products, carbon dioxide and water. So this is photosynthesis and this is cellular respiration. That's really cool, the equation of life on Earth. Let's just add the missing parts. Okay, energy in light comes in and to this arrow drives photosynthesis. Water and carbon dioxide can be converted into biomass in the presence of light through the magic of photosynthesis. And biomass and oxygen gives out energy and carbon dioxide and water. So when you eat food, part of that goes into cellular respiration and that gives you the energy to do all the things you do. And you give off carbon dioxide, you know, put a bag over your head, eventually you die. No oxygen, too much CO2. And probably didn't know that actually you convert food into water as well as carbon dioxide, a little bit. Okay. And eventually, all that energy is released. You either convert it to heat and give it off as heat, or you poop it out or pee it out or whatever, but it leaves. What comes in goes out in terms of energy. Okay, so you need to know this entire equation. It's the equation of life on Earth. If you know one equation in your entire life, better this than pi r squared, okay? Because you're alive. You should know what the equation of life on Earth is. Okay, so I have some questions for you. Wait a minute. First, okay, let's get real. Here's some lettuce. It's a plant. You just said you can explain all life through the equation of life on Earth. Can you explain lettuce now? Well, yes. So in this lettuce, I guess light is falling on it, and somehow the lettuce is getting water, yes, through its roots, and somehow it's getting carbon dioxide, okay, and it's converting that stuff by photosynthesis into salad. Okay, that's great. And we eat it and give it off. So that's pretty straightforward. But I don't really see how carbon dioxide's getting in there. I just wanted to show you a cool picture. Look, this is the surface of the skin of a plant, of the epidermis of a plant. And you can see all these little mouths open like fish. And they're called stomata with guard cells. And they're opening into the interior of the plant. And the outer surface of the plant has got all this jigsaw puzzle-like cells that keep it watertight and closed. And air can get in and out. So carbon dioxide enters and oxygen gas leaves the surface of the lettuce through these stomata. You don't have to know all that stuff. I just thought it's cool. They look like little coffee beans. Okay, and yes, of course, we eat this stuff. So the energy, the biomass, the energy in the biomass travels throughout the ecosystem. It starts in the photosynthetic organisms, and then it's transferred to us when we eat it. My wife is always on me about eating lettuce, she says, for the nutrients. But you know what? There's also energy in there, too. Just the energy. I'm a skinny guy. I need my energy. Yeah, I get some from lettuce, but I also like ice cream. Okay, anyway, here's the question I wanted to ask you. Here is just the bare bones of the equation without the details in it. And I would give you something like this on an exam. And I would put the letter A here and B here and C here and ask you questions about it. So let's just go through these questions, see if you know the answer. What does the right pointing arrow represent? Well, if this is water and carbon dioxide, the right hand arrow with energy coming in is photosynthesis. That's the right answer. What does the left point arrow represent? Left pointing arrow, that is when we get biomass and oxygen and it's burned inside our bodies to give off energy. That is totally two words, cellular respiration, two words. Do plants do the left pointing arrow? Do plants do cellular respiration? Many people say no and are wrong. Plants do photosynthesis during the day, but at night they don't, and during the day and the night they have cells just like you or I do that need to burn sugars and produce energy to do what they need to do. And so plants do both cellular respiration and photosynthesis. Let's see. So do animals do the right pointing arrow? Do animals do photosynthesis? No, not as far as I know. Maybe Elphaba, the Wicked Witch of the West, she had green skin. Maybe she's photosynthetic. I don't know. But most of us don't. Okay, so say no. So the only organisms that capture energy from outer space, are, well, plants is a good answer. Excuse me, plants, and there are some photosynthetic bacteria. But we'll just say plants. The only organisms that capture energy from outer space are plants, and without them, the rest of us would be dead, non-existent, toast. We wouldn't exist if it weren't for those photosynthetic organisms. That's why it's the equation of life on Earth. In the process of storing this energy, they're storing energy as it comes in temporarily. Plants capture what chemical compound? Well, they actually capture two chemical compounds. They capture carbon dioxide and they capture water. In the process of living, the rest of us release what chemical compound? Well, we release two chemical compounds. We release, wait for it, carbon dioxide and water. Okay, good. Okay, so, and then what's this arrow here? That is energy being released. Through cellular respiration, we release energy. We can use that energy to keep us warm, to do the things our body needs to do, but eventually it goes off out of us. Okay, so study those. And I just was nice. I put the answer to these questions here. So there they are. You can pause it, write them down if you want to, or review the video however you want. Make sure you can answer these questions. Okay, this is often summarized. This whole idea of the equation of life on Earth is captured in various kinds of diagram. Here's one that shows a giraffe eating a tree. So I guess it's an ecosystem, I guess. We'll be talking more about ecosystems soon. But what's happening in an ecosystem is energy is running through it. Sunlight is coming in and it's leaving as heat. In the process of moving through the ecosystem, producers, that is plants and other photosynthetic organisms, are capturing that light, converting it into chemical energy, which is biomass, and then that is transferred over to consumers. So here's a consumer eating it. Maybe there's insects on the trees. Maybe the biomass dies and the decomposers consume it and the heat goes off. The other thing that happens aside from the flow of energy through the ecosystem is that chemical nutrients, which we're going to talk a bit more about in the future, cycle. That is, the energy locked up in biomass is used by organisms to pump nutrients into them, and they grow, and they die, and they cycle. So there's chemical cycling in ecosystems. We'll come back to that in a future lecture. So in conclusion, I just want to show you this little video here. Sebastian participating in the EOLOE, Equation of Life on Earth. Here's Sebastian.
Sebastian, hey!
I'm going to turn the sound off. Sebastian's dad doesn't know I'm using his video for this class, but he posted it on YouTube, so I'm using it. So what's this kid? You know, when you learn the equation of life on Earth, you start viewing the whole world in a different way. Here's this kid, and he's full of energy. He eats food, and his body is digesting most, not all of that food, and how's he using it? Oh, he's running around, he's laughing, he's thinking, he's growing, he's getting bigger, and when he gets to be old like you and me, he's gonna stop growing, but he still needs to replace his skin and grow hair and nails and have thoughts and move around, and we're using all that stored energy that derived from photosynthesis, the equation of life on Earth, and we're giving that energy back to the universe as we grow up. And as you look around, you see not just Sebastian here and his dad, but also there's grass in the background, and that's doing photosynthesis, and wood chips there, which came from trees, and they have full of energy. And all that 99% of all wood is carbon dioxide and water, C, H, and O, and is given off when it's burned. It goes back into the atmosphere. So it really changes your life, I hope, to know about the equation of life on Earth. And I hope you've enjoyed this lecture and think about it. Think deeply about it. It's important. And we'll be talking more about it and similar stuff soon. Okay, ciao.